Alright. Aerith said it was cool.
Alright. Because you know what's funny is that what I heard was Solomon was already nerfed from the arcade version.
Maybe. It could be. Sure, so at least in Leo.
Alright. I like the way Leo plays.
VF?
Yeah, exactly.
Fighter?
Maybe that's why he picked it, because he's so familiar with it.
Yeah. Or Leo Fimple, like a VF character. Yeah.
Very nice combo.
Omar also plays at least in Cross Tekken sometimes.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, you could have rolled out of that.
Yeah.
Avoided the damage. Finish his chain, no punish.
Yeah. Alright.
Nice grab. Get the wall carry.
Like I watch Tekken 6
sidestep. I think that's a parry, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Not too familiar with Elisa. It's been a while. Nice low jab.
Yeah.
A lot of movement from Elisa.
Yeah.
See, Omar's been practicing movement. Very important in this game. Whiffing leads to death.
Yeah. Positioning yourself right is very important.
Gets the bound. Carries him to the wall. He doesn't continue the combo. That goes for a different setup.
Was that a taunt?
No. When they taunt, they glow.
Oh, okay.
So like a yellow. Some characters have like special taunts. So like Brian, when he taunts, it leads like to different moves you can use off of.
Alright, so I guess I'm just gonna stick with Leo.
Mm-hmm. I think this is 2 out of 3. Right.
Yeah.
Now.
Ooh, nice. He read the sidestep.
That's counter hit.
Okay.
When you taunt, you get a counter hit on the next hit. Omar trolling with that unblockable. Jesse's not blocking. He can block a lot of this. Omar's not using a lot of lows. There's a lot of high end mids.
Hopefully he's pressing buttons. Hopefully he's not trying to block
nice,
it by
nice
going
to throw.
Those chainsaws. That puts him away.
Slow on the wake up. Don't want to get caught in another setup. Launcher punish into bound. Nice combo. Just one more hit from Leo, one solid hit, this should do it.
Oh, just jab him.
I think that's 4-2.
Dropping phones. Anyway.
Oh, you could have bounded after that.
Yeah.
Launcher, no combo after. Yeah. Drops it. Can't drop combos in this game.
Very crucial that you don't
nice
do that.
Nice throw.
Ooh, nice. I don't know.
Pops, I don't think he wanted the jump.
I think he wanted a sidestep.
Probably, most likely.
Again, another jump. Yeah,
from Jesse this time.
You're going to see that most new players do that.
Yeah.
For instance, Jesse's case. Especially in my case, too.
Nice, good job.
Yeah.
Omar takes it 2-0.
Hey, good
Elisa.
Took that very convincingly. Who we got next?
Yeah, who's next?
I know, your phone was on the floor,
huh? Oh.
Who's up?
Yeah, they did.
Yeah, I know. That's what I said.
Play solo?
You can. They say you can play solo, but I think it's too good. I think it's too good. I was like, we can put in Tekken 6. No,
you know more than I do. Yeah. Hey.
Sure on who?
Class mechanics.
You're against Shiro, right? Yeah. What? Already? Who made these brackets? Evans. Not expecting this match till finals. So we got Shiro coming up. He's about to use Lars Jin. What's up, Jesse? How's it going?
What's up?
Not
like
much. The game.
It's good.
You haven't played it too much, huh?
No.
No.
Not at all. Maybe like 2 or 3 hours.
Play Leo because he's similar to a VF, right?
Yes.
Kind of like Lion.
Kind of. He's kind of like a mix between Leon and Akira.
Yeah,
with
Akira,
that,
yeah,
the shoulder
yeah.
push. Mm-hmm. You actually know this game a lot more than I do.
Just a tad bit. It's been a while since I played Tekken.
Do you like this better than VF?
I do.
You do?
There's more creativity you can use in the games with all the balance and different stages.
Yeah.
There's a lot. It's just a very fun game.
Yeah, it's weird to get used to the five button layout,
yes.
I think, because you have to, especially, like you said, the creativity with the... With the combos that you can bring in, I forgot what that's called, the crash, I think, the team crash?
Yeah, there's team bound crash.
The team bound crash. I think that's a very interesting mechanic. It's definitely something to get used to, especially since I didn't even get a chance to play the original tag. I mean,
not a lot of people have. A lot of people are still new, trying to pick it up.
Yeah.
Tekken's one of those games you have to play for a long time.
I played a little bit of Tekken 6. Nothing too serious.
Yeah.
And then I played this, and I was like, this plays nothing like Tekken 6.
No, yeah.
Well, I mean, they did change all the characters for the most part. Sean's probably using both Jax.
Yeah.
Yeah, he uses Jax and P-Jax. Yeah. I've seen that on Facebook.
Mm-hmm. I think we're playing on PS3, right?
Yeah, we're playing on
PS3
tonight.
I remember we're playing casual, we're playing on Xbox, and Sean was dropping a bunch of stuff, but we'll see now.
He was saying he likes playing better on the PS3 pad.
Yeah.
Just
preference-wise.
I was watching Shiro play. He's got this game down so far. I mean, these are two characters that I've seen him play in Tekken 6 when we have played it here. And he has some pretty creative team combos
and
that I've set up.
He has nice setups, yeah. A lot of frame traps with Jin.
Yeah, I've seen that. I've seen that he has those stage combos. That was pretty interesting.
Yeah. Drops the combo with P-Jack. Oh, gets the bound?
Ooh, that's...
Flops in Jackass. You get bound after this.
That should be
wall,
it. Yeah,
wall damage.
That was nice.
That was the end of Shiro.
So Sean takes the first round.
That was low.
Sean has also been playing this game for a really long time.
Yes, really, really good.
And he's.
I think Shiro and Sean are the best Tekken players.
Probably, yeah, for sure.
Five.
They're definitely the two best that I've seen out here.
Really well.
One thing that I have to commend Shiro on is blocking. I don't know how he knows where people are going to go.
He's very familiar with the chains and how to punish it.
That also probably comes with how much he's played the game, so.
This is pretty much the only game he really plays. He's been waiting for
and what's,
game
I remember maybe about 6 months ago seeing him play the demo on Hybrid.
Yeah.
So.
Wall combo? Gets the bounce, falls in. Oh,
see, that looks fancy. Sean comes right back, and that's two rounds. Sean
doesn't really not scared to doesn't even swap when he's low health. He's pretty confident with
his
character.
They're also very heavy characters, a lot of health.
Yeah, a lot of health, do a lot of damage. Actually, no, I think they both have the same health.
They both have the same health.
Yeah.
Ooh. Yeah, I probably would have switched there.
Hit.
That was really nice, though.
He was crouching, so when he was rising, he was still crouching at that hit. Jump kicks, they go over mids, some mids, and lows. Or even punish mids. Run kick, dash kick.
So is that why Shiro is throwing up some of those jump kicks, kind of to bait a mid?
Kind of.
Or to see it.
Dodge a low or something and get a counter hit. Because in this game, you get different moves on counter hits that cause different properties. So maybe a crumple or a stun.
Ooh,
or maybe even a bounce.
Ooh, he dropped that.
That
should have been it right there.
Lars was still full health, though.
Oh, you know what? He swapped out. I didn't even pay attention to the health bar.
Very important pitch in this game. You could die really fast.
Yeah.
See, like that? He hit him four times. Jin's a little lower than half health.
Yeah, a little lower than half health. And that's
the bound. It should be the end of it.
That
or
should be it.
Even close.
Nope. Oh, he drops it.
Swapping.
Still pretty
3%.
Confident here.
Tags in like that are not really safe.
Yeah, I noticed they're very punishable.
As they're running, you could punish. You could even, as your character's tagging out, that can still be hit.
Yeah, the first time I played that game, or this game, I got really upset at how many times I've gotten hit on a tag out.
Yeah.
Ooh, let's see. See if he can finish it here. Oh, he drops it.
Dyson Jin is more confident with him. lot more frame traps and setups.
And he also has Rage with him. Yeah. That should be it. He can give him the Russian kick for the end. Sean takes the first game.
It's a strong team. Especially if you don't know, like, I didn't play a lot of Jax, so I'm not too sure on what he can do. He just hits really, really hard.
Yeah,
he has hits, combos.
Yeah,
he's just good.
From everything that I've seen from Jax, just the little bit of I know, he's a very heavy character. He deals a lot of damage.
I haven't seen any grabs from Sean yet. He said he had some grab setups with them. Punishes with low too. With punish. No,
he's gonna get
there.
Some wall damage.
Softening Jack S. I think that's cool when the character rolls toward the screen and like the camera, that dynamic camera angles swap around.
Also, like some stages you get dirty. And you get, yeah, that's pretty cool. Pretty cool little
kinda like
add to the game.
Ballsy effect.
Yeah.
Or like Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, Mortal Kombat with the blood.
Yeah, the costume damage.
Yeah. Ooh, nice grab.
No setup really. Goes for some lows. Sure does that a lot with Jin on your wake up. He'll just go for low again.
Yeah. I've seen him do that a couple times. Had the pressure there. Couldn't do anything.
Low roundhouse with Jin hits really, really hard. He's a good, decent amount of time.
Nice tagging.
Lara's really good at carrying to the corner, and then Jin just being to do so much damage against the wall. He doesn't have good damage to Apple overall until he gets you to the corner. And he can put all that Jin pressure on you.
Nice.
Whiffs.
See what he's got here. Ooh, he drops it.
The mix up after that dynamic intro. Oh, actually,
We got Sean breaking up Shiro's momentum here.
That's what you gotta do. Once Shiro gets on his momentum,
it's hard to stop
him. Like that.
It's really hard to stop him. So that's one game apiece.
Last game. Already intense.
Yeah, I mean, I think this is gonna be a good tournament. I wouldn't be surprised if you see either one of these guys in the grand finals of this tournament. Shiro again with that momentum, but he dropped it. Yeah.
Could be character specific, just like in VF. You know, on how the
weight and stuff like that.
Some combos drop. I know, like if you play the bears against the bears, you have to do different combos and everything like that.
There goes that wall pressure.
Tag smash.
Yes.
I think with the tag crash, you lose all that red health, so you can't
recover that. Yeah, you lose all the red health. I learned that the first couple times I played the game.
This should be the end of it.
The Russian kick for the win.
Yeah, he could have done that like four more times.
Nice.
This is a double launcher. Nice low. Create some space. Roundhouse.
Ooh.
Overhead.
Gets him to the wall. Got him to the wall. He's going to get the crash.
Back to Jin.
Oh, tags him back in.
Loses all that red health. I'm not sure if that was the better decision. See, I don't get why all those birds are just chilling on the stage.
Yeah.
They got a giant robot and a karate fighter.
Yeah, you know, that's a smart place to chill.
Unsafe tag, but doesn't. Sean doesn't get a good.
Let's see if Sean can finish this combo here.
Ooh. Yes,
let's
see
if he's got it.
Shiro stop blocking.
Oh, that should be the end of the round.
The bound, and the Lars, and the wall, and then back to Jin. It's crazy.
That was straight up damage. He's trying to get him into the wall here, so he can get his momentum going.
He's overhead. He was crouching.
Oh.
10-hit combos.
Sean did a good job there. Trying to break Shiro's momentum, but it backfired.
Did not tag in safely. Okay. Last character still got hit.
So we got Shiro up two rounds.
Tags in Lars.
Shiro can close it out here.
A lot of movement from Lars. Hard to figure out what he's doing. Unless you play him.
He's a really quick character.
Yes.
And I mean, Shiro's, like you said, have been playing this game for a long time. He knows how to move.
He has a lot of mid, low mix-ups. So he will get you.
Like, I'm having a hard time following him. He's going so fast.
Sean's punishing with Launcher in the right spots, though.
Still a very close game. That's going to be it.
Oh, good set. Shiro takes it.
And that's it.
That's it. That's 2-1 Shiro.
So Shiro takes it.
All right, who's next?
I think it's probably you.
Yeah. I haven't played yet.
What? Miguel in batting 10.
Oh, snap. Looks like I got a bye.
Lucky.
Yeah. Make Omar playing, I'm guessing, solo still with Elisa.
Yeah.
And I think Miguel, I'm guessing, is going to be using Kazuya Miguel. Of course, he's going to play Miguel.
Yeah,
his name is Miguel.
He's got the same name.
Yep. Starting to learn the game. He's getting better.
I was going to play my Leo JC team, but he was playing one character, and I didn't want to...
No, it's like... You shouldn't have, like, that's just an option. So, like, if they pick solo, don't feel bad if you pick.
Well, I know, but the solo option is so much stronger than the dual option.
Yes.
in that situation. So it's just like to be a fair fight for me. I felt like it was a good choice.
I remember watching one of the Japanese tournaments. I forget, like, I think it was on Tekken Busters or something like that. And Armor King just played solo. He took second place. Against the, you know, top Tekken players.
Yeah,
so.
I mean, that doesn't surprise me. I mean, yeah. Both King and Armor King have a high damage output, especially with their grabs.
Yes.
I mean, those grabs
are deadly. Armor King and King, they can also wave dash.
Oh, yeah. Let's see, I think we're getting ready to start this.
P-Jack, what? Oh, wait.
This might be a button check. Is button check?
Yeah, all right. I think this game is really good. The Harada team did very well. A lot of options, a lot of uses in tech, in training mode. You know, like hit analysis, you can have the computer do a set of combos, like up to 5 actions, you know, either tags or certain things, and
yeah.
You learn matchups like that. It's really good. I haven't even touched online mode yet.
You know
I've
what?
Just been, you know, in the lab.
You know what I really like about this game is how it has the sample combos?
Yes.
A lot of games, they don't give you that, you know what I mean, that base.
Yeah.
Like, they don't give you the, for like a beginner player, like, you know, say myself, it's really cool to be able to, oh, you know, what can this character do?
Yeah.
And... You know, for you know some of the more experienced players, they can base you know some of their combos off of it, build off of it, make their own combos.
And like, if you notice, if you go through the sample combos, it's like they start off launcher and then ending chain, then they go bound, and they got counter hit setups,
Then
they got the last combo, just really something really fancy.
Yeah.
So, but it like it shows you which moves you use to pick up people off the
ground,
which one's the bound. So you just take moves and then you create your own combos. So just
it's got a really good system.
Whereas in VF, it's like, you know, bread and butters all day.
Yeah.
Well, when you get the launcher, it's just bread and butters.
See, we got, what is he? I didn't see who he picked.
Kazuya and Miguel.
Okay. So you're going, he was going with the team you were talking about?
Yeah. He does play JC, but I don't think he's going to play her this week. He didn't get the DLC, so he can't play Michelle. I know he wants to play Michelle Chang.
And he was telling me the DLC's banned.
No.
No, the DLC is not banned? That's what I thought.
Well, actually, I think it is banned just because of the actual release. It's free DLC, but the DLC characters are released October 7th, I believe.
Oh, so they're not so technically
so
launched.
Like, if you didn't pre-order, you can't practice that matchup.
Okay,
I see. It's just 4, so it's just Kumitsu, Michelle Chang, Ogre, and Angel.
Okay.
So, it's not too bad. It's fair, right? If you can't practice the matchup, then, you know.
So you haven't touched the online play, so you don't know how it...
I heard it's godlike. I've asked other people how the online is. I just, you know, I'm still, like, in the lab just learning back characters, different combos, what to tag in and what to do.
And this game is not one of those games where you can just learn combos and be good at. You really have to learn movements and how to get up and stuff.
Combos
like that.
Is, you know, should be like the last thing you learn. It's about movement, which normals to use, how to create mix-up.
Yeah,
just reading.
This game is a lot like VF, where you have to know frames.
Yes.
Oh, well played. One round apiece.
Side step.
Both playing very defensively. And then...
Stop blocking.
Let's see if he gets hurt here.
That wing god fist drops the combo, though.
That trade.
Oh, both crumple.
Just low.
Nice grab.
Run, grab.
Oh, and, ooh, oh, he breaks the grab.
He should end all. He drops it. Should have done a slaughterhouse. Get the ground bounce.
Miguel has two rounds.
But then again, if you play solo, you can't benefit from, you know, tag crashes.
Yeah,
you know.
Very true, very true. And one thing that I've noticed, it's not as easy to do a two-player matchup when you play solo, because you can't manage, you know, because he can manage his bar, his health bar.
Plus, if you really read the player, if they're playing one character, then, you know, there's no mix-up. You know what they're going to do.
Yeah, you know exactly what they're going
to
do.
Another character.
Ooh, nice grab. Wait, try
you
to
should
to
tag in because benefit from the rage.
So that's two rounds apiece.
Last round. 4-3. Good poke by Kazuya. I like it because it reminds me of
Kick nice
step kick. That's throw punishable.
Crumple, we'll see if he can convert here. He tags in Miguel.
Alicia and Rage doing a lot more damage.
Whew. That was a big damage combo.
Just a low. Oh,
oh
no.
Nice. That first game goes bad in 10.
Yeah. It's hard. He's saying. Huh? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, the controllers are different, so, like, you know, when you switch from, the, you know, playing on Xbox and PS3, Wing Goffis, pretty much any of the Mishimas, doing Wing Goffis is very important.
Okay.
It comes down to 13 frames, so that punishes a lot of things in this game.
Okay.
And if you do regular Wing Goffis, so without the electric, that could be punishable.
Okay.
So not being able to do that as playing a Mishima really hurts. So...
And
that, because he's, you know, he plays on Xbox. Some people have both, but oh well.
Sometimes it's like you said, it's a hard transition from Xbox to a PlayStation Plaid. Or
maybe in the future we should do casuals on PS3 or just more sessions on PS3.
Well, I know we're trying to cross over to having both PS3 and Xbox because people play different consoles.
Yeah.
But I think you're right. We should probably.
We're like one of the only areas that use Xbox really for just tournaments in general.
Yeah.
Most places you go to, they just use a.
That was a
Wing Goffis. He did it. Avoids wake up. Gets the launcher
right here. That should be round.
Tech.
That is.
Ooh, nice.
So we got bat and tear one round.
I really hate Lisa. I hate the character.
You hate the character.
I hate it. Tekken 6 brings bad memories of Lisa. Oh well.
She was pretty high up there in the tier list, wasn't she?
No, she's just kind of gimmicky. The tier list in Tekken 6, it was pretty much Law Bob, Steve, and the Mishimas, excluding Jin. Well, Jin's the Kazama, because he doesn't have a Wing Goffis. Double Jin has one. So, make out with the rage, combos. Gets the bounce
nice.
Soon. There we go. Does not tag in. Just keeps him Miguel.
He's got rage though. He needs to
Gets
go.
The launcher. This should end.
Oh, he dropped
it.
Uh-oh. That's not looking good. Oh, he brings in
Kazuya.
Kazuya here.
Gets another launch. Drops the combo.
Ooh, that's round.
Combo's dropping everywhere. Quez is not even playing.
Quez is not even playing.
Oh, nice grab. Slow on the wake up. Yeah. I might have
right here.
Play next, but. All right.
Ooh.
Actually,
that's.
Oh, where'd he go?
Bad 10 takes it there.
Bad 10 takes it 2-0. With Alisa in solo mode. We get a little disappointed.
Yeah, I mean
the game's still new, fairly new. Still learning.
He's still new to the game.
I'm up. All right.
Oh. So we're gonna have Shiro and Reggie here. Waiting for them to get on the stream station. Just want to thank you guys for watching. Somehow this is this winter semis already? Winter semis already? So Reggie got lucky and got a bye all the way to winter semis. Oh hey, I'm on TV. I think you want to commentate here with me, Bug? You know about this game. Well, you know Tekken. I've been phoning it in, just kind of.
Looking good.
I've been doing all right.
Well, this sounds weird.
Yeah, you can hear me. It's weird. I can hear myself. It's kind of weird. Boop. There you go.
Yep.
So, are we button checking here? Or are we okay? So, how you feeling going into the tournament? Do you think you have a chance to take it, or
still? Yeah.
I missed some key stuff, but be alright. Be good. Step it up.
Yeah, like I said, it's still new. I mean, it's not Tekken 6. It's a whole totally different game. Don't know much about the game, but been enjoying it nonetheless.
Yeah, it was a fun game. I love this game. I want to learn some more. I've only got like maybe 3 tag combos up right now, which I didn't really get any of them off correctly for some reason. P-Jax, happy hands. He pushes up, put it behind me instead of in front of me. He's supposed to put him in front of me for a shoulder tackle, but it's all right. Hopefully, maybe if I do it a little bit later, it'll land.
We'll see. I mean, so you're in losers now, right?
Yeah. So it's going to be a long road ahead if I'm going to come back.
It's not too bad. I mean, Reggie got a bye all the way up to winter semis here.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Yeah.
Well, let's hope he earns that spot.
If you're in losers, I'm in losers. So it looks like we might be actually playing each other. I don't know. So I mean,
that'd be fun.
No, I mean not for me. You actually know what you're doing. I have no idea what I'm doing. I mean, like I've probably played this game a couple hours. I've learned a few things here and there. I like the characters that I play. I just don't know how to use them together yet.
Okay.
So
you'll get the tag comboing is crucial in this game. In Tekken 6, you feel a lot more comfortable because you only have to really play one on point. But in this game, you have to play both on point. And you endanger one, and pretty much you can cost yourself the match easily. So
we got the first round here. Shiro, I noticed, when he has his momentum, you're not going to stop him.
No, he's doing, when he gets it going and he's predicting it pretty well, it's pretty good in his favor, definitely.
Nice tag combo by Reggie there. Ooh, let's see if he can convert off that.
There he goes. He gets the bound late.
Some fancy stuff.
That's good. All right. Okay.
Oh.
He's got a little bit of momentum on his side.
Oh, Shiro grabs him.
He's going to have to.
That's it.
Yeah. And the key to this game really is a lot of sidestepping. Which I should have been doing a lot more of in the first place, but
this game definitely a lot of sidestepping, a lot of maneuvering, and Shiro, I have to hand it to him, his freaking movement's ridiculous. Like I was watching him play, and I had a hard time, especially when he's playing Lars, had a hard time following his character movement. Nice wall damage there.
Yeah, that's why I would call in a tag crash, because his ability to cover the get-ups, Lars, is pretty ridiculous. And if you get up and you block low, then he'll come in with a quick mid.
Okay.
And even if you block the mid, it's still enough pressure to where you can put in something else. And that's how Jin is, too, to a point. But if you can duck his first hit, you usually get something off before he can hit you. But Lars is a little bit more tricky. And as you can see, like, Jin stutter... feints to his lows are a little bit easier to see coming than Lars, because Lars has such big movement in his, while Jin's is more incremental, and he's like, you can see which leg is coming, you know. With Lars, he's doing all kinds of stuff, and his whole body's twisting, and you don't know what's coming at you at any one time.
Interesting mix-ups.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
See, like, I didn't see that coming, and that was like that animation was really like really simple animation. I didn't think he was gonna go low, but I don't know this game, so I'm I thought he was gonna like wind up and do like a push type of thing. Nope, he just kicked him.
A key thing to kind of remember is when you get under about 20% to down to about 10 or 5% of your health, it's almost guaranteed a low is coming your way.
For sure.
Not always. If you're playing a smart player, they know when to come in with a mid too, because they know you're expecting.
Yeah.
But more often than not, you'll find them going for a low to get that easy. I forgot to block low.
Yeah.
It, you know. Nothing fancy. It's not
like
cool,
every 3D fighting game.
Exactly. Yeah. It's not cool. It's not what's gonna get the crowd cheering, but it will get you the win.
It gets you the round. Yeah.
That's right.
I think a good way to stop Shiro is to stop his pressure. Is to stop his pressure early on and keep you away from the wall.
Yeah. If you can get off the wall and kind of get behind him and turn it around on him, it'll set you up.
Because I noticed when he really likes to do those crash combos to get Lars hitting you up against the wall, get a lot of damage off. But if you can somehow get him to stay away from there, you might have a chance.
Mm-hmm.
And I noticed when you were playing him, more often than not, when you got him away, you actually took the round. So it's just trying to stop his momentum.
And you gotta be careful, because in this game, you know, you could do that.
Yeah.
You know, one round, and then the next round, the other guy could do it just as easily. It just depends on how far they get in your head in the game. So, and that's the key thing in this game is steady nerves, because it's so much of a rock paper scissors type atmosphere that
very similar to VF. Similar to VF. I feel like a lot of times, too, you'll get a lucky launch and you just have to convert on it. Like, you just have to know that, oh, shit, I can do something here.
And if you don't, you're really going to find yourself missing out on key opportunities. I did that a couple of times where I missed a couple of auto launches or magic. They call them magic fours in this game. When you hit a kick and they're midair, and it basically kicks them and holds them there. And then it sets you up for a combo just as if you launched them.
Oh, okay.
And so it's a magic four. It's usually on counter hit.
Okay.
And it'll just pick them, pop them up like a launcher, and you'll be good to go.
That's two. Shiro takes that pretty easily. So, I don't know who we got. Who do we got next? Oh, I got actually play.
All right, Jesse, get in there. Who are you playing?
Right now I'm playing Leo and JC.
Coming in hot. You got it. From last week, you're perfect. That's everybody. That's everybody since last week. Look at Juan over there using Fang. Come on, Juan. What are you doing? All right. Button checks. Bro, you can get on here. You don't need to know the game. You just sit here. And you talk about how wonderful your life is. That's about it. Everybody wants to hear what you're doing with your life. Don't care about me. At all.
All right. Mario here.
With the best burrito. Combo
from Taco
burrito.
Bell.
From Taco Bell.
Best commentator for Tekken. All right. Who we got? All right. Forrest, Kazooie, Leo, JC. All right. We know what this is. This is gonna be a match. Alright.
This is gonna be good. Here it comes. Alright, let's see if Reggie can play on point like he was.
A little lag, right? Is it, yeah?
A little bit.
Yeah, okay. Alright.
Jesse gets that first grab. Oh, doing pretty good on the defensive side of it. See if he can keep it up. Oh, there it is. Trick in this is to bend but not break. If you let him get too far in your head, you're breaking. Definitely. Alright. Little knockback by Jesse. Another one. Could have rushed into him for a blockable tackle, but that's good. It's all right.
Juggles.
Oh, better switch out. There he goes. All right, coming in. Got to stay away from Leo with that rage. He's going to have a lot of power on him. Oh, there it is.
Juggle.
Drops it. Oh, with the feint into launch kick. That's nice. There it is.
He's going to eat the
classic
wall
bread and butter. Yeah, he kind of got out of the way of that wall, but we'll see how long that lasts.
Look at the dolphin. Oh. Fuck that. Look at the dolphin.
Back there playing beach volleyball back there. In the pool.
Jesse was distracted by Dead or Alive 7 over there.
I know. I saw him. It's not doing the same justice for him. She's the pretty lady sitting on the rocks.
Drinking Ciroc.
Uh-oh.
Juggle that shit. Oh, he went for a grab.
Yeah, some characters in this game have launch grabs, which is... Oh, my gosh. It's ridiculous. That little grab to knee thing is just it's a free launch to a bound and to any combo you want.
Oh.
Flip kick.
Oh.
Oh.
Guile theme?
Took one to the stomach. Gut check. There you go. That's how we start off the first one. See if it helps him win this time too. Seems to be the way to go. Oh, taking his heart.
Every other hit they can take, but just like the one to the gut, it's just makes them fall down.
Oh yeah, that just gets him too good. He's got to be careful here. You got to switch out.
Even before I
nice
about these games.
Yeah.
These games in a professional point of view, I always knew Law had some juggles.
Even
Tekken 2 with, only the three friends that ever played, it'd be like, man, let's try to be Law. Just, juggle the shit out of people. That was dope. All
right. That was a good match. Let's see what happens. The thing about Leo is he can do a lot of stopping in between his hits. And so you think he's done, but he can take that moment of pause and then hit. So a normal fluid combo he can turn into like a chunked up combo, you know? That way it catches you off guard, so you go to hit instead of block and then take a counter.
Lee's the one that has the kicks, right?
Lee.
Yeah. Okay, all right, cool.
Lei's the one that's Jackie Chan.
Okay, yeah.
Now if you can use Lei, and you really can use him, gosh.
Ooh, Lei,
he's
remember
the hardest
him.
One.
Oh, shit.
He's like the hardest person to play on point, but
wait,
I'm telling you.
What was that one move that literally went like half the screen that Lei had?
That he launches himself?
Yeah. Oh, damn. I want to see that. That move has to be in here still.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fuck. Don't let this be a perfect. All right. Reggie's getting revenge since he's lost to Shiro.
Hopefully I'm after that same event. You know? Let's see.
JC said, let me just take some hits for you real quick. I'll try to avenge you. Juggle. Wall bounce. I don't think that was the smartest, but...
Whoa. He should have probably... I don't know if he...
How many open levels are there?
Surprisingly, maybe like 4 or 5. There's not a ton.
Out of
20. I mean, they all have something. Floor break, wall break.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Something to that effect. Most of them. Okay. There, you know, there's a couple of infinite outs.
Yeah.
But not a whole bunch of them.
Okay. So.
Miguel!
I bid you good luck.
Give a shout out to Sean.
Now we got Miguel.
I think I'm kidding, but I might not.
we got Jack and whatever other person he uses versus Miguel. You used both Jacks? John? Oh, what? Oh, shit! It's about to go down.
Both Jacks.
Is this yours, good sir?
Yes, sir.
So how about that StarCraft?
I play every day. I pay attention to that more than any of this.
I used to.
Did you?
Yeah.
That's cool, bro.
I was Masters Protoss.
Cool. My brother's a Masters Protoss, but then he switched to Terran. I think now it's just Diamond. Terran? Yeah. But I stay Zerg. I don't know. That's cool.
I played Zerg first, but they're hella hard, so.
Played Terran. Well, because in Brood War, I played everybody. Like, it was like, I can pick random. I was just going throughout my day perfectly fine. But this one came, StarCraft 2, and I was like, fuck. Yeah. And ended up picking Zerg.
My queen macro was shitty, so I quit.
Ended up finding out my race was the shittiest, so.
Yeah, Zerg is the shittiest. Have fun with that.
Terrible. I do. Terrible.
Or Idra, I guess. His name's Idra.
Yeah. What about him?
He's hella good. He's my favorite player of all time.
Same. He's my favorite player. Stefano won WCS Europe.
Yep. Against, I don't know his name.
I think it was Vortex, I think.
Vortex, yeah. Vortex.
He had to beat his brother to get to the final.
Yeah, what's his brother's name?
Lucifron.
Lucifron. Who was
I pay attention to
that. Warcraft 3 player.
Yeah, he did, but.
He played Night Elf in Warcraft 3. I know that. I don't know why. I never played Warcraft 3. Hmm. Alright, but Tekken. Let's go.
Alright.
I hope Miguel picks Chance Miguel. I don't think he did. He should have picked Chance Miguel, though. Miguel loves this game. But Sean, the muscular black man, has his faithful Jax.
He has his game face on.
Yeah,
and we're just
using Kazuya right here.
Oh, no button checks at all. They are both using Kazuya.
Half health, almost there. Miguel's not a 3D fighter. And this is Sean's favorite game. So.
Yeah. Every time I've seen Sean here, this is the only... Like, if it's guaranteed that Tekken's gonna be here, he'll be coming. Only him and Shiro will probably play this the most. When would you stop playing StarCraft?
I can't tell you because we're commentating Tekken.
Oh, we're... Damn.
That shoulder check by Miguel is really
strong.
That move is really quick.
Oh. Nice. Interruption.
That's one of the prospects of this Tekken game. You can tag out there.
Wow. Rampage. Rampage.
Both of their main characters here.
Yeah, sure.
Throw breaks get you in the corner. I did not know that.
Ooh, I love that move.
That move.
Punish.
Yep. Kazuya, decent juggling character. Jax is not. So I think
Sean's in the zone.
Yeah, I think Sean's relying on his Kazuya more.
He's relying on his classy mechanics right now. FYI, Sean moves while he plays. Like, physically moves while he plays.
Yeah.
to see this guy play a racing game.
Like connect.
While listening to music, Vinny does the same thing. He brings his beats and Dr. Dre and Sean to be fancy. And
Sean
in
is
the
like
zone.
Really in the zone. He wants to win.
He's still winning.
His real competition is Shiro and Reggie, though.
Yeah.
I mean, Miguel's good, but not really real
ankles, ankles, low attacks, always. That's a nasty jack. That's a nasty jack.
Sean has been playing jack.
Yeah, for a long time.
E-Man has it. E-Man has it. On Street Fighter, E-Man has it.
Gotta slow Sean down. I don't know if that was the right one. Yep.
I don't think he felt comfortable with the Kazuya-Miguel match, because Kazuya is really good at those footsies. He has really good pokes to start his strings. And Miguel's more of a power hitter, just like Jax is.
Yeah. First round he got on this.
Nice. He waited for that tag in, but he couldn't capitalize on it.
Oh, good.
Jax famous get up move.
There we go.
Oof. What the hell was that?
I've never seen that.
Yeah, me neither.
Look at the donkey carrying the dog and the cat and the chicken.
I think that's a rooster, good sir.
Oh, yeah. As if there's nothing else is going on. Oh.
You got a wall splash, buddy.
This switch. Oh.
Oh my gosh.
That would have been the best switch decision if you made. Oh.
Nice.
That was solid. That was solid.
He has one more match to get this. He just knows what button to press when. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
And that more than any other game. In Tekken, that's the most important thing. Footsies is literally everything.
Yeah. Oh, good. That was nice. No rest for the wicked. Yup. And he's still reliable with his jack. He can clean this up.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh!
That was the charge-up punch. He was so scared of it.
He finished with a shebang.
Good game.
That was good shit.
Sean with the Mirror's Edge shirt on.
Dope as fuck.
Mirror's Edge shirt.
Your shirt, Mirror's Edge. Your shirt, yeah. Good shit, that was dope.
So about that StarCraft.
When would you quit? But a better question, can I have your account? I have like four. I just switch them daily. I put in work. I'm just joking about that.
Okay. I was going to say, yeah, but...
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, word?
But I also have like $500 worth of World of Warcraft characters. So
of what?
World of Warcraft characters, so I don't know if I should do that to you.
Do you sell them?
I did.
Oh, dang. My friend played a lot of World. Her friends played a lot, and they said they were talking to me about they sell those accounts. Like, dang, that's crazy. Yeah.
$1,300.
Yeah, yeah. That's pretty crazy.
Phil plays so much, so much. But I just love StarCraft. I actually love watching it more than playing competitively in that game.
They say that's the biggest spectator esport.
Yeah, it is.
Because, I know, and I agree because I pay attention to all of it, but something about just watching it that people get into. Like, all the accounts I have are people that used to play, good friends, and they just stopped playing, but I'll talk to them about it. He's like, oh yeah, I'm still watching Minigun stream and all that shit. I'm like, oh, you watch, but you don't even play.
I think that more than anything is like, if you want to play Marvel, but you're not good enough, you don't have the good enough execution or footsies, or you can't guard well enough, you don't have good enough defense, you don't go and watch a stream. It just doesn't interest you if you're not good at the game like that. But with StarCraft, if you don't know how to macro effectively, and you go on stream, it's just so interesting, the chess mindset of Korean and American players that are competitive in that game. It's like almost like Street Fighter. That's what makes me hype about Street Fighter. It's like just the chess competitive mindset of the top players.
Right,
you can actually see it.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Right there. It's crazy.
But I literally haven't watched any StarCraft in like 5 months. I watched a little bit of the Stefano game against Vortex, but I caught the very end of it. That's it.
But no, just stop playing. You stop. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right on.
I moved to Minnesota, and so I didn't have my computer for a bunch of days. So I got caught behind. And it's not really something that not like these games that not like these games where if you get behind it significantly hurts you, because you could just jump in any StarCraft match and be like, wow, this guy's really good.
Yeah,
wow, this is really intense.
Yeah, yeah.
But
shit changes.
Yeah, I just couldn't do it.
You leave for 6 months in StarCraft, there's new strategies, so.
Yeah, the game gets patched, and I quit when Zealot Archon was getting really popular. That's when I quit.
I never really got, well, I'm not gonna, I don't wanna, I know how to handle Zealot Archon, but I never really, like, had it, like, again, I never really fought against it all the time, but.
Reggie plays Private Jack? Or is this backwards here?
I have no idea.
That's news to me.
I know.
No, it looks like that's Sean.
It's reversed.
Yeah.
Twins!
Hey, twins!
Hey!
Twins!
Reverse the name.
Alright, they should be reversing their names now. Sean's still with, or Classy Mechanics, I'm sorry. Still with his double Jax team here. Probably not too scared of the amazing footsies of Kazuya anymore. That was amazing.
That was vicious.
Private Jax, of course, the new Jack. And Jack 6. The Jack from Tekken 6.
Oh, the dancing?
Yeah.
The polka? This seems like a hard-ass game. No, I meant, wait, I don't know what I meant by six. I meant matchup.
Oh, I don't know. Jack is pretty slow, so you can easily out-footsie him. But like I said before, Sean's been playing this character,
yeah,
he's so
yeah.
fucking used to that. Look at that! Oh
yeah,
God.
Yeah, it is vicious.
He just knows all of the mind games to play on his opponent's wake up.
Yeah.
With these specific movesets. He's going on perfect right now. He's looking very good. He needs to switch his character. There we go.
Yeah.
He
had to do it.
He got a wall splatter
down.
Oh, he could have got big damage there.
He's gonna have to do a
still
lot with
still looking really
jack.
Good. It's still a perfect. Oh, never mind. Oh, shit. Nice. He tries to go for the overhead there.
He's gonna have to make a huge comeback.
The bounce, but he missed it there.
Yeah. With this juggle,
there
he can
go. Yeah. Sean just needs one more to close this round out here. Whoa!
Oh
my gosh, that was so cool. From what I know, Sean learns his own combos.
Yeah. I don't know who else would do double jack.
Yeah. Nice. You're really really good combo.
I was talking to Phil. I mean, that's what separates like good players from like pro players is that they make. You don't wait for someone to make combos for your Captain America or whatever. No, you make your combos for Jack or
you make
it for him.
Whoa.
Yeah, Sean kind of does that.
That open palm from Dad.
Yeah.
Why did it zoom in so much?
Oh.
Ooh. It still come back from
this. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Well.
That was sweet, though. Too much. It's one match away from both.
Yeah.
Almost the entire point of this game is to wall carry, juggle them to the wall so you can get a wall splatter, because a wall splatter allows you to almost have dropped another it, prospect in your combo, like a wall bounce. For more damage, though.
Oh, yeah.
And he does. Ouch.
Wow.
The full Jack 6 there.
And that's his first game.
I think Sean was saying he forgot that it automatically switches
characters.
Yeah, it does.
I don't know if Reggie was, you know, tapping down kick as fast as possible, but, you know, he got it through.
Got a lot smarter there. Oh, we got it that time.
Got that. That was beautiful. Alright. Didn't connect. Yeah. Juggle. Yeah.
Just continue. Oh, missed it.
That was just as effective if he switched it. Like. Yeah.
Crumple right there.
There we go.
Wow.
That was
so much damage.
That was revenge for that last round. This is a good match, man.
That combo looks so simple and it does not too much damage there.
Oh, yeah. The seconds pause difference.
Nice.
Yeah. He's gonna have to switch. He doesn't. Yeah, perfect.
Oh, we almost got him off the stage there.
But then it was. You have to do a lot.
Sean's looking a good blunt here.
Yeah. Yeah. Ooh. Oh.
Whoa. Man.
Ooh.
Nice.
Don't let him. All right. Good. That was intense.
Just needs one more round to get the set here.
The exact. Same thing that happened last time.
True.
Yeah, two up and then went down.
And doing that charge kick to take half of Private Jack's health is
already.
Oh, but they're even now.
Oh,
okay. My gosh.
This is a killing blow right here. All right.
Nice overhead there.
Now what he should do is just try to get the most out of Private Jack, but it looks like he rounded it up.
Nice. That was a really nice string by Reggie to conserve the rage that Forrest had as long as possible. Wall splatter. He doesn't capitalize on it as much as he could have. This is not going Sean's way.
There we go.
Wow, full combo.
Yeah, alright. Snap the switch.
They both switch, so it's even now. Not too much anymore.
Yeah.
That custom combo was wonderful.
Might, yeah, switch. I know he learned a mistake from last time.
Yes, he did. He adjusted there. This is looking like Sean. And he
let him wait for it. Oh, okay. Alright. He can play this patiently.
Yeah, he can. But he's Sean, so he won't. He plays Jack for a reason.
Yeah.
So he can get up and
wake
that.
Up.
That's
the wake up, yeah,
Jack.
And then the wake up stabs. Alright.
Hey, Sean.
Sean.
Hey, Sean. Sean.
Is it?
Sean.
It's on Reggie, so.
I want to see Sean do that that butt sliding punch move that Jax does. I want to see him do it right now.
Alright. It was best out of three, so this is the last one.
Yeah. I wonder why he switched right
there.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Maybe he prefers Private Jack. Nice. I wonder which variant does more damage, the punch or that.
Yeah.
Slanted punch.
He was a little bit more patient with him.
Nice punch.
He has to switch soon.
The frame traps by his jack are almost.
If you can,
they look perfect.
Oh
my gosh, that kick is ridiculous.
He went for the polka dance, which to kill him off, but then he switched to the
Wall
Slide. He's not gonna let him.
You got both of them
right
there.
Oh, X Factor that shit. Just get the most out of P Jack and you're solid as fuck.
This guy almost got it there.
Look at that.
Trails get the charge, the low punch, but he just backs up. He's fishing for those uppercuts right now.
Yeah.
I'm not ordering to wake up.
Don't let him.
Those crouching ones there.
Be safe, you can switch. Yep.
Ooh.
Yep.
I didn't
know
that much of a twist there. That was it.
Switch to be safe, and then he did the.
One here. Sean's on his last round. His winning round.
Match point for Sean. Classy.
Nice.
It's looking solid.
Forces him to switch.
That literally brought it all back. Yeah. Alright. Reset.
Nice.
Yup. He's good with his jack.
Yeah.
The jack 6 is his man,
nice, so he has to switch there. One more good poke by Reggie.
Yeah.
It's over.
Oh, there we go. With the rage.
Nice. It's not gonna end him. He just needs one more.
Oh
my God! Are you serious?
Get money.
Are you serious? The Panther
dive. The dive though. The dive.
McDiver.
All right. That was solid as fuck.